I love my piano. It's a great instrument for understanding, playing, and creating music. Hi, this is Crystal. Here is a piano keyboard with notes colored according to their name. And here is sheet music with notes written on staves, which is the plural of staff. A staff has 5 horizontal lines and 4 spaces, and is used to visually show notes. What pitch each note corresponds to depends on the clef and its position. The top staff has a treble clef curling around G and represents the range for common tones. The bottom staff has a bass clef with dots around F and is used for showing lower notes. Now, I'm going to play notes on my piano from C below the bass clef to high C above the treble clef. As each sound is played, look at the piano to correlate the key and staff paper to see where that note is written. The first and last note was a C. On a piano, C is the key to the left of the set of 2 black keys. There is no black note just below C. On this drawing, there are 3 Cs. The white keys are called letters between A and G. That's 7 notes, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And then the pattern starts again. However, a common key is C major, and its scale starts with C, not A. So it goes from C, D, E, F, G, and then A, B, and C at the end to bring closure. This scale starts with middle C and is played using only the ivory keys. Next are all the C notes played on my piano. The lowest and highest notes aren't very in tune, but that's okay because I rarely play them. Now that we've tickled the ivories, let's look at sheet music again. A grand staff is 2 or more staves joined together. Because this grand staff has a standard treble and bass clef, on the invisible line between them sits middle C. Each note has a stem because these are quarter notes. The stem points up for notes written below the middle line of a staff, and it points down for notes on the middle line or above. If middle C were written on the bass clef instead of the treble clef, its stem would be pointing down, just like the brown B just below it. Middle C is key number 40 on a piano, which has 88 keys, so middle C is a little to the left of the middle. On a piano, middle C is generally aligned with the left side of the manufacturer's template. Of the 88 keys on a piano, 52 are white and 36 are black. Even though you may not play many of the black keys, they're useful for your fingers to find the right white keys to press. Learning where the C's are and being able to train your fingers to find them is good practice. Here are all the C notes played on my piano. Oh, the highest notes sound like bottles being bashed around, don't they? Here are some of the C notes played together. Notice how they are harmonic with each other? I could get into waveforms here, but that will have to be another lesson. The scales I played for you are in the key of C major, which means the first note of the scale is a C. On the piano, this scale can be played using only the white keys. The shorter black keys are for flats and sharps, which are used to play notes in other keys. Note the difference in the use of the word key. In one sense, key refers to a single note being pressed down. In another, it refers to the starting note in a scale, or key, like C major. If your ears are really sharp, you might have noticed that my piano uses 432 tuning. That means that A4 is tuned to 432 Hz instead of the standard concert tuning of 440 Hz. 432 is more harmonic with the natural frequencies of human bodies. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. There's a link in the video description to download a handout you can print and reference. Music touches us in a way that words can't. Music is truly a universal language, with animals and plants, too.